There are some kind of outsource links where you can explore a lot of things such as LinkedIn profile, GitHub profile, showcasing that all in kind of resume or data science internships, and where I used to share all the interview process and how to prepare for data science interviews. Resume really matters a lot. Assalamu alaikum beautiful people, welcome to another video. So I hope you guys are really doing very great. At the same time, today I am going to share you my data science resume, which helps me to get 4 data science internships and a lot of data science and analytical opportunities. So basically, building data science skills is kind of thing, but showcasing that all in kind of resume and projects, at the same time, lot of achievements in resume will really matter a lot for getting lots of data science opportunities. So today I am going to share you my resume, which helps me to get a lot of data science opportunities, and a lot of things help me to get evolved in the data science career. So at the same time, I hope you guys have watched my recent video on my 4 data science internships, and where I used to share all the interview process and how to prepare for data science interviews, a lot of things. And if you haven't checked it out, the link is in the description and you can go through it. Okay, and without wasting time, let's jump into the session. So as you can see here is my resume, where I used to put all of my things, my achievements, my work experience, my skills, technology which I know, the technologies which I worked upon, a lot of things. So before going to the particular resume topic, so the most like there is a lots of mistakes that most of you guys are doing, because I build my resume on based upon and guidance of a lot of highly professional data scientists. So on based upon their guidance, I build my own resume. So as you can see here, my resume, where I used to first of all discuss about my work experience on related to the particular path, and coming to the education history and projects which I worked upon, and the achievements which I gain, and I think a kind of links regarding my LinkedIn profile, GitHub profile, and my personal links, and a lot of things like the software which I know, and at the same time professional skills, and what are the some kind of conclusions. So basically, while building any kind of resume or selling any kind of resume, this is one of the most important blunder mistake is happening. Because one second, I will show you. If you see here, my resume file name was sheikhsamiruddin_resume. So one of the recruiter from one of the top company has discussed with me that the most of the resumes get rejected on based upon the, like, by seeing the file name itself. Most of you guys are just keeping some kind of crazy names, and some of the game guys are not even naming the particular file, and some of them are just mentioning the like some kind of cool words, but it's not the thing, which it was really very bad thing, because you need to name your particular resume file with your name underscore the particular resume. So that shows your professional and your interest towards the particular internship or job. And coming to the next part, so the things like the more you need to attach some kind of outsource links where you can explore a lot of things such as LinkedIn profile, GitHub profile. Like me, I have attached the particular LinkedIn and GitHub profile here, yeah, and my YouTube profile also. It's not a profile, it's a channel basically. Okay, so maintaining like the main and important thing was maintaining a highly professional LinkedIn profile will really helps a lot for getting any kind of data science opportunities and interview calls. So in my case, present I am working upon my 4th data science internship, and most of the internship, like 2 to 3 internships, are get selected only based upon my LinkedIn profile name. So please guys, please don't neglect on building your LinkedIn profile. Building means there is not a way of just creating the account and just sending the connections. Maintain a healthy connections. What I mean by healthy connections, just keep some kind of relationship, I mean professional relationship between you and lot of professional connections that you connected to. At the same time, post some kind of real relevant technical stuff through LinkedIn. At the same time, maintain an active GitHub profile, so that like posting or like uploading all your projects which you have worked upon. At the same time, if you haven't work upon any kind of project, that's completely fine. If you just go through, you can also attach it. So the thing was, in my case, I also published my first research paper. So I also attached a particular link off here. At the same time, see, after doing all the particular stuff, you need to mention some kind of important points in, like, it's kind of bullet points in resume, some kind of statement that I helped something, so I am passionate about this, and I worked upon this, some kind of 1 or 2 sentence at beginning of the link resume. And photo is, it's up to you whether you want to keep the photo or not. At the same time, don't run behind the resume themes and resume a kind of good looking. Just maintain a highly professional and at the same time good looking resume. At the same time, mention your hobby. Only mention the skills and technologies that you worked upon and that you know. Unless until just if you don't mention any, you just keep machine learning, they will only concentrate upon that kind of part that you don't know, because they will easily catch the particular guys because they are highly experienced in recruiting. So don't try to bluff and cheat them. They can easily caught you, and they will just reject you. And at the same time, they will play you before rejecting. Just be honest with your resume. And at the same time, don't mention a kind of price that you haven't heard about or haven't worked about. Don't please copy paste. If you like, the most of the job interviews will be only based upon asking your projects and what is your role in it and how you deal the particular hurdles that you faced while building a particular project. In my case, I worked upon some kind of data analysis and some kind of prediction parts. So I can explain them because I have only worked upon those kind of projects. At the same time, they will ask you also some kind of internship. They will ask you whether you have some kind of interview experience on it. So in my case, I used to be tell about I have previous internship experience and I have worked upon this kind of project in previous internship, and my role was this in particular internship. I can just tell a kind of story, a good story. It's really very helpful for explaining our strategies and everything. So coming to the next part, in my fourth data science interview, I mostly calls upon asking the technical part, but also behavioral part also most important. Like please don't be focused on some kind of only technical, but also be like just have a look on the behavioral questions outside the internet. Like they will ask a kind of questions like why I need to select you for this particular role out of 500 or 1000 applicants. So this kind of behavioral questions will be asked to test your mindset. So be strong with that answer, sir, and don't try to bluff. Okay, I'm telling again and again, don't try to cheat with the skills and the product that you haven't worked upon and that haven't known it. Okay, at the same time, coming to the next part, they will ask you some kind of based upon the resume, they will in my previous internship interview they will ask me some kind of questions, and they asked me to tell me about my research paper. So where I used to work from. So I think my interview was nearly 2 to 3 rounds, and the first round was nearly 40 minutes, second round was 30 minutes, and third round was it's again 40 minutes. So like on crossing and on clearing all these rounds, only I get my fourth data science internship. It was really very tough on cracking all, like the tough means if you haven't prepared, if you are well prepared and confident at your part, it will really very easy to crack any kind of data science interviews. Not only data science, it irrespective of the domain. Okay, like I have nearly 10 to 15 resumes, sample resumes, which was selected for the data science interviews, and I will mention all this resume in my description. If you want, just go through it. Okay, it's one of the senior data science resume. Just ignore it. I will show lots of resume in my file. Yep, he's the one of the guy who has 3+ experience where he used to see how he explains his experience and the some kind of educational background and links like GitHub. See, links, providing links will really help you a lot in the skills which he know, and I think that's it enough. Don't be try to complicate your resume. Just keep simple and shorter. Okay, and I think I have a lot of resumes in my folder. I will create a kind of folder with all these resumes, and I will put the particular travel link in the description. If you want, just go through it. Okay, so coming to the final part, if you want to crack any kind of data science interviews, try and go and try out of some kind of Kaggle competitions and try to attend them and try to solve the particular Kaggle competition. Like I know it will be a bit tough at starting, but day by day it will really help you a lot for gaining lots of experience for solving. See, putting your Kaggle profile link will also give a lot of weightage to your resume and boost your data science career. So for cracking any kind of data science, I used to prefer to go to Kaggle and solve. See, in data science interviews, they will not even concentrate upon your technical skills, and they will not even ask how you like Python coding skills. They will simply just give you some kind of data set and some kind of problem statement, and they will try to conclude it. Whether you use any kind of machine learning, deep learning, data analysis, simple linear regression is up to you, but they will tell you to just conclude them. So by concluding by the answer which was given by you, they will start questioning from them. So don't always try to work upon some kind of lots of old projects. Try something new, like go outside, try to apply data science in real life and try out some kind of new projects. And there are lots of research papers coming day by day, day by day. Just go and read at least one research paper for a week. That gives you really, really lots of good ideology and logical thinking skills for cracking any kind of data science interviews. So guys, I hope this particular video is really, really helpful for you a lot for how to build a kind of data science resume and at the same time how to prefer and crack any kind of data science interviews. And guys, I recently nowadays I'm making a lot of videos regarding projects, and if you haven't checked out my list of data science projects for beginners to advanced, just check it out. The link is in the description. And if you really want any kind of help related data science skills, projects, resume building, any kind of stuff, just comment me. I will continue. I am not a pro guy and I am not a most experienced, but I have lots of connection so that I can connect them to you and they will help you a lot. Okay, so guys, I hope that's it for today. See you in the next video. Until then, assalamu alaikum, beautiful people. My head in the clouds, I don't know where we go. I feel like it's changed love. I'm losing my mind, feeling that kind of love. I feel like a deep hole. Will you give me something that I can't give you here? Tell me what you're thinking. I need to know your feeling.